So we're finishing up a job here north of Denver. This 1950s trailer home. We built a CottageRocket heater about 3 years ago. It's been working nicely. It's cut the fuel bill by about a third, but we want to see what we could do to improve it. So here's our final installment before we head out. Checking on it. We rebuilt the firebox to replace broken brick and get it a little more efficient. We replaced the heat riser. That's the tube that goes from here, from the feed chamber to the burn chamber to the heat riser. Is a chimney that's insulated that goes up through the mass and gives us our thrust to have everything burn hot and clean. And we had built that before out of insulated fire brick. Those were crumbling. So we replaced that with a ceramic wool insulated stainless steel riser. And we'll see how that one weathers the high temperatures in there. But we've got these two barrels here, about 1 1/3 barrels. This one down low is hollow to allow the exhaust coming from up here, which is also hollow, to come down through tubes and out through these pipes through our new cob bench. This bench is half barrels screwed together and held up on cast iron legs to allow heat to circulate under there. With a wooden floor, you don't want anything warm directly above it. This heat will build up. Here's our clean outs. And the exhaust comes back over here and up the chimney. You can see the clothes dryer here. This works very well. And this is our fuel. The tin man's bringing in nice little chunks. A chunk like that'll burn for an hour or so. These little things are nice for getting a quick hot fire. And we'd improved the heat shields back there. So we're excited to give it another 3 years, see how it behaves, keeping this place warm.
Mud here. The most important proof of any design is how well it holds up over time. So we're really excited to get the chance to dismantle and inspect our 3-year-old CottageRocket, then rebuild and upgrade it on camera. We're happy to say it's aged pretty well, but we're also eager to show you which supposedly high temp materials couldn't handle the heat. Some of what we found may surprise you. If you really want to geek out about rocket heaters, we have a special 2-part extended video for our patrons only. Over 45 minutes of footage from our 2-week teardown and inspection and rebuild of this tiny house rocket mass heater. Join us at patreon.com/UncleMud to get access to this and a whole lot of other exclusive mud and fire content for as little as $1 a month. Thanks for watching. Stay muddy.